Hello, everybody, and welcome to the 20th Sweet State, a monthly sort of video series where I talk about the state of this channel and anything that's pretty much on my mind. And the music you are hearing is, of course, Suitepee from System of a Down. My name is Suitepee. I was inspired by the band. That song for the name, so that's why I played at the start of the Sweet State. And the camera appears to have gone to position. Okay, hopefully it's fine. Let's just see. Yeah, some problems with the it happens from time to time with the OBS. Hello, Vimongadator, and hello to Drogan. How are you both doing? Just need to adjust the there we go. Got it. Okay. That band's no System of a Down, Drogan. Not Symptom of the Downs. That's just... no. So yeah, basically I just talk about stuff, you know? And the main benefit that I like about this, doing these sweet states, is that I tend to do them when my mum isn't around, so that I can talk a bit more honestly about things, you know? More openly, without fearing that I'll be questioned, shall we say. So... I've made it to 20 of these, holy shit. Feels like only yesterday I started doing this as a sort of experiment. But here we are, 20 sweet states later. Still monthly updates, still doing this thing. Oh yes. Alright, so... this may not be the longest sweet state, honestly. I'm sort of front-loading it with what I really want to get into, but after that, a lot of things are easy to an easy 20 more. Oh, thank you, Vimonginator. I hope to be around for at least a lot more. One day I hope to get to... Sweet, is your shirt supposed to be a signal to us that you're a bear? Yeah, it says grizzly in the morning. Yeah. So... yeah, it does say that. How very perceptive of you, Drogan. Okay. But yeah, one day I hope to get to triple figures, which would be 100, which would be like, what, another couple of years? Near the end of the decade, I think. 12, 24, 26, 72, 84, 96, Yeah, actually, the 100th one would be sometime near the end of the decade. So, 2029, get hyped for episode 100. By which time I hope to be in vastly different circumstances to where I am now. Hey, past self. Future self, I should say. Things were a lot worse in 2020, but everything's cool now, no matter what your future gripes are, future me. In 2020, world was pretty shit. So, yeah, that's my message to myself if I happen to watch this 9 years later. But anyway. So, I'm going to make future you suffer. You make me suffer now, Drogan. That's hardly a difference in the programming there. 2020 is the start of big things, though. Yes, that is true. It is the start of big things. I have my 10-year plan. It's a bit of a slow burner, but, you know, I got 10 years, and I am making some steps in the right direction. It's just going to be very slow. Process. Essentially, I started living at 32, and I'm sort of playing a bigger catch-up, but we're getting there. We're getting there. So, I always start off these sweet states by talking about my personal situation a little bit. Thankfully, I don't have much to report in the regards of my IRL circumstances. I'm still at college. I'm still looking for work. I'm going to have a job by the summer. My weight's going down. I need to do a few more things to make it go down better, which I'm working on. And that's about it for that. Something really drastic that has changed other than I'm running out of cash a little bit. But I will get, I can still cling on. I still got enough savings. I will be fine. I'm all good. But I will need a job by summer. That is definite. And I have started applying for jobs that are suitable. I mainly am just looking forward to seeing the end of the college course, to be honest. I'm not going to pursue a degree in computing. I have decided I'm not interested. You know, I learn about all this programming stuff and it just fucking bores me. I don't care about IT at the advanced level, you know. I mean, I'm barely, in some areas, I'm barely technically literate, technically literate myself. You know, I've had to have a lot of help with setting up stuff over the years, so I'm not really that good at it. Hey, Dan Camel, how you doing? Yeah, I know. It was part of the another one of those impulsive decisions. If, in hindsight, I kind of wish I'd saved the 3 grand and just kept looking for a job elsewhere. I probably would be in a job, but whatever. I had to find out. I had to find out if I was interested in computers. Turns out I don't give a fuck. Honestly, I give a fuck about live streaming and some software, but I don't really care to learn about programming or web design or how to design web pages or networking or stuff like that. I don't give a fuck. As long as it works, it works. You know? I'm never gonna be sort of a super IT nerd. It's not me. It's not who I am. So that was that. That's so I'm basically just gonna finish the course and then go straight back into the care industry. Work somewhere else or whatever, you know, find a place, earn some cash. That's all it's going to be to me. Because I'm going to be honest with you all, the only passion I have left in my life is doing this. This live streaming. This is my only thing I actually care about. And that's being 100% honest. You know, I mean, this is something I've enjoyed since I discovered it in 2009, and I fucking love doing this stuff. And I'm not gonna lie, if I was able to, although I don't know if I'd want to, but if I was able to, if I got myself into a position where I was capable, I would love to do this full time. But I can't. Not at the moment. And I can't kid myself into thinking I can start either. I'll get to that. But this is literally the only thing I care about. Dead serious. You people, you wonderful guys and girls, and those in between. The only thing I hate about your live streams is it starts at 11 p.m. for me. Rough as heck. Oh, well, time zones. Can't do much about that. I mean, I'd love to do more streams around this time of day. I might. But I can't. I'm gonna go over that. There is a section I'm going to dissect on that in a bit. But I'm just basically saying, I've been working hard on my first map. Have you? No, I've done some test streams. You know, I've got back into Ultimate Doom Builder and I've got another 10 months to go. Excuse me. I will be doing mapping streams a bit more regularly throughout the year. I did say I wanted to get a map done by the end of the year, so I will be working hard on it eventually. Just got a few other things to sort out first, perhaps. Heh, John streams, so it's like 5 a.m. for me, which is why I'm almost never there. Hey, Jimmy, how's it going? Yeah, I want to have 5 or 6 done. 5 or 6? Wow. You got the mapping bug, I see, Camel. Well, good luck with that. I hope your maps turn out good. Maybe a mini episode. A mini episode. I'd be interested to see what your maps are like, Mr. Camel. But yeah, this is the main thing I care about. I mean, hey, Magus, how you doing? Easy stroller, probably. You haven't mapped in a while. Okay. I mean, I've always liked video games. Ever since I was really young, I've always been passionate about video games, I guess. Unfortunately, it doesn't really translate well to a job, but it's a passion that's not gone away. I care for certain types of video games, and streaming is like the best thing that I've ever discovered in my entire life because I can now play video games and show other people, and it's great, and I love the community element of it, and It's very hard to go back to just playing games by myself after you've experienced streaming for a period of time. It's what I've called the curse of the live streamer, in a sense. And I don't think everyone suffers from this, but I certainly think it's something that a lot of them probably do have. It's like, before you become a live streamer, you play a lot of games, you have a lot of fun, and you do shit. Then you start streaming, and over time, streaming just becomes the only way you can play games because it's just so much better to play games and have an audience, right? It's hard to go back to just sitting in the dark and just playing by yourself. Yeah, you've got the bug too. Like, I mean, I had to force myself to play Assassin's Creed 1 and 2 years ago. But even then, I streamed the first part of it on the live, and I had to do the rest. I had to play those games to the end, to be fair. But it's just so difficult to go back to being a live, not a live streamer when you're playing games. I mean, you might have something you can sort of play, like a roguelite or some daily grind thing or whatever. But actually playing a full game, and I'm thinking, I could play this on myself, but I could also play this with 20, 30, 40, 50. X amount of people have live commentary and a lot more interaction. You know? I say this as if it's a bad thing. It's not really. Live streaming is like the best thing ever for video games, you know? If you can get that audience, of course, then you're set for life, probably. It's why I care about this so much, you know? Being the introverted, socially awkward retard that I am, this is a great way for me to keep my social skills up, despite what my fucking mum thinks. You know? My mum does not quite grasp this concept as well as a lot of people do. You know? In her eyes, you're just a bunch of virtual friends who aren't really there. I challenged her on that and basically called her out, and she sort of gave in eventually. So, you know, she doesn't grasp the concept that people can talk this way and this is how interactions work in 2020. Or in that kind of thing. I think it depends on the type of game. Something cinematic, collage, story based, massive energy space, being around, bugging you. Well, yes, but it's not necessarily to do with the enjoyment. You can still play RPGs and still have live streams. Well, yeah. I mean, you know, I don't want to touch on it too much, but basically she's always worried about my social stuff, but for me, this is my social stuff. This is what I do, you know. I'm fucking introverted. What can you expect? I was in a family for 32 years when my father basically decided that instead of trying to develop my social skills, that he'd take me out drinking and get pissed in pubs every fucking week. Sorry if I'm a little fucking, you know, suffering the long-term psychological effects of an abusive father for 32 fucking years and I don't feel like being social. Fuck. You know, the world is a horrible, shitty place sometimes, and I know firsthand what it's like. A part of it, anyway. You know? I mean, don't get me wrong, my mum isn't wrong. I do need to be more social outside of just this kind of stuff, but I don't really fucking care. I'm quite happy. The only thing I do need to do is become more independent and get out of this fucking house so I can live off my own means, and then I can do this as much as I damn well please. And as I've said before, when that happens, when I get out of here and get my own money and get my own place and be able to look after myself, which, no, fuck no, I'm not getting married. Fuck that. No. I'm not getting married. I'm staying away from marriage. I'm staying away from anything of that kind. Not interested. Hard pass. Not interested. I don't want to pass on my recessive genes to anyone, and I don't want to be in a relationship for 20 years and then get fucking thrown out one day and lose everything. Nah, fuck that. I'm gonna commit my life to this, my work, my live streaming, my real passion, something I care about, you know, trying to help other people, being inspiration for other people going forward. But on my, why make yourself almost some cunt taking out your stuff? She didn't earn a more Christian size when she doesn't like you anymore. I'm not that cynical, Drowken, Jesus. But from what I know, it's basically, if, well, I know you are, but I don't quite agree with that. I mean, there is definitely an imbalance there, but it's the fact that things can change on a whim. I mean, something can happen, and then if something does happen and the tides turn, if you're a man, the legal system isn't favored for you in some areas, unfortunately. So, but now I just don't want to be, the main thing is, I'm too socially awkward. I would probably be fucking poor at that kind of relationship anyway. It wouldn't last long. And two, I don't want to pass on my DNA to anyone. I'm going to die alone, physically, but I'm going to die with the comfort that I've inspired other people to do great things. You know, that's what I'll be happy with. I mean, there'll be many times when my brain will try and tell me to override that, but I'm going to say, nope, sorry. I'm happy to have inspired all these people and given them entertainment and inspiration and happiness for a little bit, and that's fine by me. You know? My sister's already continued to Budwine, so why should I care? That's what I'm thinking. You know, my sister's going to get married. She's probably going to have kids. And it's like, there you go. There's your family heritage. I don't need to infest any more people with my shitty DNA. Fuck no. And relationships are good, Camel, I agree. You know. But relationships don't have a lot of legal protections. Black pillars in chat. Yeah, maybe, but I'm sorry, but I swallow a black pill every day. That's the way it is. That's the way my life's gone. You know? But that doesn't mean I have to sit in my room all... That doesn't mean I have to sit in misery all day, however. I can use that as an inspiration to be better than all that. To be better than the first 32 years of my life. To be a better person and to be, you know, better person than my current version. I ain't never known how's it going. So, but yeah, I'd agree. Having a family can be very fulfilling, absolutely. But I could just work with kids. I can cut out the middleman. You see, that's kind of. Maybe that's partly why I do work with them, apart from the fact that I'm good at doing that occasionally. It's the fact that it basically feels like helping a child and sort of, you know, cutting out the middleman of having to be in a relationship with somebody. I never catch your streams anymore due to time zones. Yeah, I can only stream in the evenings. I can only stream in the evenings, really. Streaming, like, I can only stream today, to be honest, because my mum's currently somewhere else for the entire day, so I've got a bit of extra time. That's why I always have to record these sweet states when she's not here, because I want to be more honest in these kind of streams, because when I talk about a few things during a regular stream, I have to hold a lot back, and when she's not here, I'm allowed to talk honestly. So you kind of get, like, a raw look at what I'm about, I guess. But... yeah. So, what was I going on to with all this? You play Doom? I still play Doom Wads, but I'm sort of providing a variety as well. I'm still doing some variety. But yeah. I mean, things are going to look up eventually. I'm going to lose weight. I am going to earn some money in a job. I mean... That's what's going to happen. I'm going to be in a job. But honestly, I'm just going to treat the job as just a way of getting paid. You know, I'm going to go back and work in the care industry because it's where I've got the most experience and I happen to be decent at it. But I'm not going to treat it as anything more than just a raw job, a way of earning money so I can do what I really give a fuck about, which is this. Yeah, I am hyped for Eternal. I guess I'll mention it now since you brought it up. I am going to be playing Doom Eternal. Just everyone probably already knows that anyway. But just to clarify, that I'm going to be playing Doom Eternal. I have pre-ordered the game. I may not play it on the very first day it releases. I might see what the day one patch is first, but I am going to play it pretty soon after it releases, like maybe within a day or two. I mean, I could play it when it comes out and just gamble on it day one sort of thing and just see what happens. But I might just wait. I might wait for a patch. I don't know. It depends how I what I'm doing with other stuff at the time, but I won't be waiting too long. It'll be this month. If not on the day of release, then it will be like a day or a week after, whatever. Losing weight is a very snowball type of effect. You went down from 140 kilos to 85 or something with baby not to kind of came. It was a fucking blessing. Yeah. And for me, the weight has always been my biggest problem. You know, it's been a real struggle to lose weight consistently. I've had periods of time where I've been as low as 18 stone. You know, I think the lowest I can remember when I started weighing myself seriously was at one point I was on the very edge of, I was like 17 stone and 3 and whatever, but unfortunately I've never been able to keep the weight off. And that's something I really want to do. You know, I really want to lose about 5 or 6 stone. You know, I'm currently 20 stone, which is not great. If I could lose about 5 or 6 stone, that'd be fucking fantastic, but it's a hard process and I'm gradually tweaking my behaviors to get to that point. Which is why I've been doing the weekly food diary so I know what I eat and I have to confess to when I eat. That's actually helped to kill off my snacking quite a bit, actually. Not and another part will be to drink less and to, you know, just little changes. Changes to my behaviors that are set in stone and then I get better habits. That's what it's all about. Yeah, I weigh myself in stone, not kilograms. It's just something I've always done. I mean, I should weigh myself in kilograms, but I'd have to reassess goals, and I like the stone met weighing, so whatever, it's all good. You can't even put on daily weights, you got vaccinated for your pollen allergy. Oh. Well, there's a day one patch, I guess, if this game, if Doom Eternal has it, so it might not be a bad thing. Yeah. So, it sounds more metal than kilograms. I think it's like it's an older measuring way. Is it metric, imperial? I don't fucking know. Just what it is. Well, I do want to make a lot of positive changes, and I'm trying my best, and it's hard. But now I can finally segue to what I wanted to mention. You know, aside from all the blackpilling I'm trying to not do, but you know, I'm just that's the way I am. I'm like the doomer minus the fucking opiate addiction. Or the ability to sleep until stay up until 4 in the morning. I can't do either of those things. I don't sit in a dark room listening to like depressing stuff. But I have a very sort of numb mentality about things in some regards. But yeah. I am trying to. I just need to actually. What is I'm looking for? I need to set up something here. Sorry, just setting up something for a little later. There we go. That'll do for later. I think. Yeah, okay. Just set it up for later. So, one of the things that I want to make a ch I have said I wanted to make a change on is, you know, I have talked about for a couple of months now about the whole problem I have with my rage. You know, when I get angry at stuff and I lose control for brief periods of time. And I was trying my best to sort of avoid that from happening. But I mean, you've heard me say, like, I'm trying to avoid the rage and I'm trying to exercise control and all that stuff kind of thing. You know, the problem I've had for a while as well. And as Dave Chappelle said, if you have hay in your heart, lay it out. Well, that could be a good way of putting it. I think I've sort of come to this over the last couple of days, but I've had to realize that how to put it? The rage that I express is, for better and for worse, it's a part of who I am. It's a part of who I am at this time and possibly forever. And the truth is that I'm never going to be able to sort of dispel it entirely, no matter how hard I try. And it's really hard to, because, you know, I guess I like having that release because maybe I can't release it elsewhere. And the truth is that, you know, for years and years I've had this sort of thing, but it's never actually been massively problematic as it could have been, I think. I mean, I'm trying to describe it. It's kind of like an acceptance of it, you know. I have to accept that that is just part of how I react to things, and that's how I'm always probably going to react to some things with some kind of immediate temper that cools down quite quickly on silly and stupid shit sometimes. And obviously, I can. It's not only CBT, a psychiatrist, I guess, but it's brief. Some point CBT might help you be interesting. Got something to help to put that weight into it. It's a good start. I've tried CBT when I was going, my parents were going through a divorce. That kind of helped with some of that, but I can't really afford the CBT, and I don't know if it would help necessarily. What I'm basically trying to say is that I have sort of accepted that I am going to be like that. You know, I have that sort of short-tempered impulse. And it's not necessarily a bad thing, per se, because I've been kind of demonizing that, but I don't know if I should be demonizing it as much as I have been doing, really. Not saying that I should, like, not calm down in some cases, but what I'm saying is that I shouldn't also be, like, trying to get rid of it completely. When it's obviously a part of my personality, it's part of who I am, it's part of why people find it entertaining sometimes, because, you know, maybe it is. And I'm just kind of accepting that's just gonna be part of who I am, instead of trying to, like, apologize for it and fucking. It's hard to accept getting mad when people in chat are always pointing out and judging you. Well, I guess. You know, I mean, instead of, like, trying to just fucking get, you know, like, demonize it, I should just kind of embrace it a little bit. Not saying I should be trying to get myself mad, and I should definitely stay away from things that annoy me consistently. But at the same time, you know, I shouldn't beat myself up too badly when it happens, because it's just part of my personality. Just part of how I've always been wired, you know. I've always been wired to have this sort of. Yeah, sometimes Twitch stuff really exacerbates it. You know. I mean, I usually apologize if I make a mistake anyway. You know, it's not like I get angry and stay angry at something that if someone corrects it or points it out or whatever. I assume it's legit, maybe it's not enjoyable to watch. Well, yeah, of course. I mean, I don't want to get mad to the point where it's turning people away. Most definitely. I don't want to be, like, toxic or anything and, like, start slamming viewers and stuff. But at the same time, I don't think it's doing me any good if I keep pushing the I'm just going to stay calm. I'm just going to stay calm all the time. I'm just going to have any emotion about anything. You know, I just feel that if I do it in that way, I am perishing in my chair and I head to bed, my lad. Okay, well, have a good sleep, my Munganator, and I'll see you around, hopefully. 2020, good things coming. Yeah, good things coming indeed. Good things coming, I hope. Let me know when it starts coming. I'd like to know. Maybe the good things will have to come from myself. I just think that if I, like, sort of just completely say I'm not going to get mad at everything ever again, it'll just get bottled up. And when I do have an outburst, it will be more significant, you know. It could be like, oh, I'm so calm, and then I have one big outburst and I don't do all the hard work. It's like, it's part of who I am, unfortunately. I do have these emotional outbursts, and they can be quite entertaining, I guess, to some of you. As long as it doesn't go too far, you know, I have to accept that's kind of who I am. You know, I'm not a person who handles some kind of difficulties well. We're not saying you have to be calm all the time. Some things are just by the ways, but there are times which are more calm when the rage isn't justifiable, it's available, and then you should be tackled. Okay, yeah, I guess that is the element of it I do need to get better at. But I shouldn't beat myself up every time I get mad at something, is what I'm trying to say. I think that's what I've been doing. I've been playing like, oh, you know. Every time I get mad, that's a bad thing. It's like, no, not really. Sometimes some things are mad, and if you get mad, that's fine. As long as you just move on as when you can. It's, you know. But I'd agree, if I'm getting mad at something stupid, then that's what I need to be called out on, you know. But I've just sort of accepted that this is who I'm going to be like, you know. I can't really change it. It just comes naturally to me, I guess. You know, it's part of the thing I do when I'm streaming. And it's not exactly been detrimental over the year. I mean, it has somewhat in some people, but this is who I am, you know. And I can get a bit better at not getting rage at dumb shit that's my own fault. But at the same time, I can also just not go completely the other way. And you get what I'm saying, right? I guess. You know, it's not like I want to get mad, but I'm sort of accepting that sometimes I will, and not to beat myself up when it's something that is genuinely frustrating, like Marathon Infinity, for instance, which is genuinely frustrating to play. From my perspective, at least. So, what I'm basically saying is that I'm no longer going to be trying to, like, be someone I'm not, you know. I'm going to try to not say, like, oh, I'm just not going to get angry at things. I'm just going to be very calm and monotone about everything. I'm going to strive for balance and not beat myself up over it if I get mad a little bit, you know. That's something that's hard. So, yeah, and that's part of me trying to make less impulsive decisions, which is something I have mentioned regards to the Doom Eternal thing, you know, and what other things. I've made a lot of bad impulsive decisions about thinking them over in the past, and I'm going to try and do less of that. And one of them is not going down this path of trying to be completely calm about everything, when that's just not my personality. Basically, trying to be someone you're not doesn't work out for you. If I'm a streamer that gets mad, sometimes entertainingly so, at things, and that's the way it is. As long as it's kept in balance, it's not obnoxious to a large number of people, then I'm doing something right, you know. And that's in regards to other things too, being less impulsive, like, you know, deciding to not play Doom Eternal over personal reasons, just on a whim. Should never have done that, really. Or playing an MMORPG you know, I've learned my lesson with that. I think someone quit there at the time. You know, I'm trying to make less impulsive decisions. I'm trying to think things through when I make changes in my life, instead of just going for it and then dealing with it afterwards kind of thing. So, and that's what I'm going to do with the rage issues. I don't want to get mad at things that, hey, Mr. Zul, I don't want to get mad at things that don't deserve to be getting mad at, but at the same time, if I get mad at something I find frustrating, I am allowed to express that in a reasonable capacity. As long as it remains within reason. As long as I don't start slamming viewers unnecessarily, then it's fine. As long as I don't continue to play something that remains frustrating for long periods of time that I can't handle, then, you know, it's all good. So call it an acceptance of the rage issues after all these years. After years of saying saying I want to get rid of it. I just sort of accepted I'm just going to have these rage problems, and as long as they're kept in check, they're not necessarily a problem. It's just a tic, a quirk, or whatever it is. You know? So, obviously I could try to, I mean, maybe in the future I might gain more control, I might not get as mad as so many things, but I'm not going to try and beat myself down every time I get a little upset over something. That's the bottom line. Because obviously I need to focus more on providing good content than just trying to self-flagellate myself every time I make a slight mistake, you know. Okay, so get that off my chest, you know. But you are welcome to point out if you feel my rage has gone too far, though. You are welcome to do that. Just a saying, you know. I'm not immune from criticism. No one is, really. No one is immune from criticism. So do feel free to point out if I do sort of go too far sometimes. And the other main thing I want to... You can actually tell by chat spamming the salt emote. Well, I don't know if that's the best metric to use, but sure. I mean, sometimes people have said when I've been a little off the hinge, but I don't think I've really been off the hinge massively ever since, for a little while now, I don't think. Probably not since Dark Tartarus, to be honest. I think that was the last time I can remember that I did go a bit too far. But then Dark Tartarus was an annoying, overly difficult thing, and I should have quit that project a long time ago. Anyway, the other thing that I want to sort of address from the personal situation perspective is the other thing I've sort of been mentioning for the last couple of months as well. I did say in a previous sweet state that I was going to attempt to treat live streaming as like a part-time job. You know, you have heard me talk about the part-time job mentality, how I was going to try to, you know, provide content, regular content that would justify people sort of donating and getting bids and subs and PayPal donations and whatever, you know, treating it like a part-time job sort of thing. But in all honesty, I'm going to be pretty much abandoning that mentality for the foreseeable future. Because I cannot do it. I cannot commit to it while I live here. And part of the reason for that is because I can't stream all the time when I want to. Simple as that. And part of it is because I just can't. I just don't want to, really. You know, I really don't want to sort of treat this as any kind of a job or feel committed to having to stream at set times for the time being. I want to show this picture here. You know, a little thing there. You could probably see that. That's a comment that I took from a streamer on Dope Whips, where I still hang around regularly. One of them's called Seagull. And we were having a little discussion about Dope Whips and, you know, how, you know, things were different in the past, now they are nowadays. And he made this comment during that discussion, and it kind of resonated with me a bit. And not only in terms of Dope Whips and how it panned out, but also in terms of what I should be striving for with this. Yes, joking, whatever. Can fly, that's an advantage. It kind of sums up my sort of mentality to streaming in a sense, you know. I mean when I started out streaming, and I've said this before, I used to stream just for, you know, I used to stream, you know, back in the days when it was just a fledgling thing, and I've always sort of kept that mentality ever since. I do take live streaming seriously, don't get me wrong. You know, I've put a lot of years and commitment into this kind of thing. But at the same time, I've never really felt of it as like a job. It's always just been something that I passionately care about, in a sense. And while I don't mind, now that I'm affiliate, getting the odd donation here or a bit there, or whatever, not saying I'm not happy with that stuff, it's not really what I'm doing this for. You know, I want to make a nice sort of happy mini community, if you will, you know, where I entertain people, inspire people chat about nerdy shit or whatever. It's about having fun, you know. That's always the way I've treated streaming. And while I take the fun seriously, I don't think I could ever sort of do this as a job. I don't think I ever could. At least not while I live here, where I have no control over the hours. But even then, even if I got my own place in like 5 years, I still don't think I would treat this as a job. Completely honest. I don't think I'll ever be treating this as a job. I know I said at the start of this that it would be nice if I could, you know. But I don't think, realistically, I ever could or would or should want to. You know. Because if I started treating this live stream like a job, then it would change. And I think it would lose its charm. Because there are days where I don't want to live stream. Simple as that. I get bored. I get a bit of fatigue sometimes. I might want to do something else. I might want to take a day off, go do something else. If this was my job, I couldn't do that. Because essentially, this live streaming is really my escapism. That's kind of what it is. It's my escapism. And if I turn my escapism into an arduous and forced grind for cash, then it would just lose its charm for me. It would just be a thing I had to do. I'd probably grow to resent it. You know, it'd start off fine at first, for a little bit, and then at some point I'd just get fed up. And I'm not saying that, you know, I'm not saying this to look down upon streamers who do this for a living. Obviously, they can do that. They enjoy doing that. I'm saying for me personally, and only me personally, that I don't think that if I treated this as a full-time or even a part-time job, even if I could commit to a regular schedule, like 4 hours a day every single day, that I'd enjoy it in the long term. I think I would just grow to get fed up, you know, because I couldn't take that break off on a day or a week or whatever, you know. I want to build up something that money really cannot buy, and that is a nice, pleasant community of great individuals to talk to, you know, for a couple of hours on any day I see fit, you know. Not, I mean, obviously Dope Wiz is different because it's got multiple people in it and it is a community. But I've always had that sort of mentality, you know. That's why I took my time to become an affiliate. That's why I've really been hesitant to sort of implement these monetary additions, because that's never what streaming's been about for me. It's always been about having fun, talking about stuff, finding new experiences, and just delving into escapism. I mean, could you honestly see me as a full-time streamer doing this 8 hours a day, every single day, doing variety and just plugging away? Could any of you honestly see me doing that in like 5 or 10 years or whatever, or next year or whenever? You know, do you think, could you honestly see me doing that ever? I love this water. Probably gonna come off a bit of a hangover. So I'm just giving a moment for chat to respond if anyone's still around. Oh, hi, Pineapple. How you doing? But yeah, I've just been basically saying that, you know, could anyone ever see me being like a full-time sort of live streamer who just does this for like a career or something? I don't think I could ever do that. It'd be a lovely pipe dream to have, but I don't think I could do it, and I don't think I want to. I honestly think it would lose its appeal for me. So I'm giving up the part-time job mentality. I'm not going to give up affiliation now, you know, but I'm not going to force people to do anything. I mean, I might sell donation targets in the future. Until I get a job, then I probably will drop those as well. I'll just be able to purchase. I mean, to be honest, once I get a job, I'm probably going to drop the donation targets, unless it's for, like, a good cause or something. And it's just, it's always an option, you know. I'm not doing IT work, Pineapple. I'm basically going to complete my college course and go back into the care industry and earn some money. Simple as that. I'm just doing the college course just to get a pass, a nice little certificate, and then I can go back into care. I gotta wait until June to get out, and then I can get a full-time job and be working back in where I used to in no time. I guess the chat doesn't really have a lot of thoughts on that, or else the chat's just really quiet for this point. You know, I mean, I'm never gonna force people to, you know, to donate money to me. I'm never gonna force people to be subscribers. I'm never gonna force people to give bits. I'm never gonna beg for donations or bits or anything like that, you know. I'm never gonna, you could watch this, you can watch my services for free for the rest of time, honestly, and I won't mind. You recently started a friend, Python, to improve just BuzzFeed. Yeah, we are touching upon Python in the procedural programming that we're learning, but I find it fucking boring. I mean, I could sort of get the gist of it, but it just bores me. I don't like the idea of programming. I know what some of you do, and I'm not going to knock it. Programming is an interesting, is a good skill to have, but I'm not interested in it. I'm really not. I don't care for IT, really, beyond the base level. You know, that's the honest truth. But I'm glad it's going well, Pineapple. But that's the way it is, you know. I want to just do this for the fun of streaming, for, you know, to, you know, just for fun. And in the future, when I get my own place, and when I earn my own cash, you know, I'll still be doing this for fun, because that's what I want to do, you know. I never want to do this and feel forced as if I have to live stream. Any subject is boring if you have a boring teacher. Well, it's just I just don't care about IT stuff, Pineapple. I'm not interested. I mean, I get the gist of some of it, but I don't want to pursue it further. At this point, I'm set. I just need to get back into care, earn some cash, get my own place, get out of this house, have my own existence, and then go from there, really. Well, if you don't like problem solving, then I cannot recommend problem solving. I guess I've solved quite a few problems with the kids I've worked with in the past, but I just don't care for IT at all. But that the bottom line is that getting back onto what I'm saying about the part-time job, I'm just not gonna do it. I'm just not having that mentality anymore. This is purely just for fun, you know. If you want to donate, that's up to you. That's your incentive. Yeah, it's true. That's all it is. You gotta keep it simple, stupid. Just what they lose. I'm happy when people do subscribe and donate, but I'm not doing the streaming just for the sake of earning, you know, X amount of cash. That's just a little bonus. I'm mainly doing this because I want to play new games, have new experiences, helping inspire people, entertain people, and just, you know, build a nice community. I mean, I am gonna study metrics. I've said this before. I am gonna, well, John, if you ever change your mind, I only get paid if someone has a job because of me teaching them for them. You want to get paid? Okay, I'll keep that in mind, Pineapple. But you know, I am gonna. I do want to grow the channel. I do want to see some growth. I do want to try and get, you know, a growth. But I don't want to do it at the expense of feeling like I have to stream all the time when I'm not in the mood or if I'm doing other things. You know, I want to do this just for fun. And that's always the way it should be. It should never, this should never feel like an obligation because I should be doing it because I want to do it, because it's fun and it's enjoyable. And 99% of the time it is. So, no more talk of this part-time job mentality and no more beating myself up every time I get a little upset at things that we, you know, that's the main things I've sort of decided to adopt. And I think it's better because then I can just focus on just making good content and playing games and stuff instead of worrying about like part-time job and beating myself up all the time because I get a little upset at a frustrating fucking level or something. And you know this, I want to build a community first and anything else is a bonus, you know, anything else is a bonus. I'm happy if you just show up and talk with me for a bit. So, just throwing it out there. It also made me realize that why Dope Lives is so great as well, because they're a community first and a streaming site second. I just never really had it put into words for me, and then I realized, but yeah, it's all good. Okay. So now I've front loaded. That's the front. If you can afford it easily, then you can't. But we people naturally even teach to get them to a point where you're able to start winning for themselves. And here's Pineapple giving some Python advice. So, what else is on my sweet day agenda? Well, I've said I've played Doom Eternal. I've already covered that thanks to Jimmy's query. And just to it, and I guess the next thing is just to remind you all that the Kynikos Dragoon target was met. I think you all know that already. I'm just sort of reiterating it here, but it got met. Thanks to about, how was it, 60% from you guys and girls, and I sort of contributed the rest to complete the target. So there was a picture linked in the Discord, my Discord, of Kynikos with the new unit. Things are going okay in that department. I think he has to change the SSD that came with the unit, but other than that, it's all good. And you know, it's helped improve Kynikos Dragoon's life. So we did a good thing. And thank you to all those who contributed and donated and made awareness of it. We did a good thing there, I think. That being said, I won't be doing that kind of thing in the future, necessarily. At least not without consulting you lot. You know, that was enough of that. While it was a good thing that I did, it was also an impulsive decision. And I don't want to do that kind of thing anymore, where I make impulsive decisions. You know, there might be stuff in the future where there might be someone I want to help out, or a charity or whatever. But in the future, I will be consulting with my audience and my moderators about it before I make these kind of decisions. You know. But we helped out Kinnikos, and that was all good, basically. And speaking of moderators, yeah, basic IT courses are kind of like that, Draukin. I think there was a website that was quite useful that they sort of linked in my course. Let me just see if I can find it. It might be able to help. I think this is it. Yeah, here we go. There's a useful link for you, Draukin, if you want to get into like computing and stuff. I used a little bit of it. It teaches stuff like HTML and JavaScript and Python and all kinds of stuff. It's like a free online sort of tutorial for various basic computing things. So that could be useful for you. So that's a useful link. And speaking of new moderator, Bridge Burner is now my new Discord and Twitch moderator alongside Draukin. This was not an impulsive decision. I actually had Bridge Burner lined up to be a moderator for a while, but while I had two moderators, I didn't feel the need for a third immediately. But things changed slightly, and as soon as there was a slot open, I knew that Bridge Burner had to be the guy to... Hey, Dark underscore Art, how's it going? To fill that slot. So, in a nutshell, basically, Fuzzball Renekitty was my moderator. She has been busy with other things, so she just wanted to step away from the role. And Bridge Burner was appointed to replace her. And that's basically it. So I now have two moderators again, providing different perspectives on things. And in a way, they kind of perform a nice balance to each other. Draukin is my longtime friend who I've met several times. He's been with me since the beginning, the very, very beginning of myself as a streamer. Draukin provides the perspective of experience and also variety streaming. You know, he remembers my times on Dope Lives where I streamed all kinds of things, and he provides the voice of playing other games. And then on the other hand, Bridge Burner represents for me as a moderator the Doom community. You know, he's experienced in the Doom community. He makes stuff for it. He's a voice in it. He represents the side of me that wants to do Doom stuff. And because of these two sort of different opinions, I think it provides a nice balance on the moderating team. I have the perspective of two different opinions if I want to go over stuff. So, yeah, that should be good. Wow, Pineapple's looking for a job, looking for some cash here. It looks like. So that's that. And that's the thing I'm going to be doing going forward. I'm going to be trying to achieve this balance. I know, and I've said this many times before, that a lot of reasons that people come here is for the Doom content, you know, because this is what this channel started off as. It started off as me playing Doom Wads as a side project from Dopewiz, and now it's become the main attraction where I spend all my time. But I'm going to try to find a balance where I play Doom stuff and I also play other games. And I know obviously the balance has been heavily skewed towards Doom, but I'm going to try to sort of tip the scale so it's a bit as close to 50-50 as I can get, you know. I don't want to just play Doom, but at the same time, I don't just want to do variety either. I want to strive to a nice balance to appease the side of me that wants to play Doom stuff and the side of me that wants to do everything else, you know. And that's why there'll be other games. You can see many of them down below in the lists of Draugen's list alone, and as well as the others. And there's lots of other things I want to play in the future of different game genres, never mind just FPS games. Although FPS games are a big passion and I will play a lot of those. There are, excuse me, other game genres that I do want to explore in the future. You know, I want to kind of get back to the, at least in part, the sort of the Dopewiz thing where I played other games. You know, RPGs, want to play a few of those. Maybe an RTS here or there. Definitely would like to play Command and Conquer. At least the first two old ones. If I can ever get that set up. Maybe Tomb Raider 1 and 2 at some point. Other things like that, you know. Retro and modern. Stuff that just takes my fancy. You know. But making sure it's all balanced. I don't want to be all variety and I don't want to be all Doom. I want to be in between. And but for the time being, I am going to be focusing on the long-standing requests. Those requests that have been waiting for years. I'm going to be tackling those initially for a little bit. That's why I did the Marathon trilogy with Imp Boy. He requested that way back. Pretty sure he requested it back in 2013. So he's waited 7 years for that one. And the next one I'm going to be playing is Unreal. And Draugen's been waiting for that for about 10 years, I think. I'm pretty sure it was requested and gifted to me back in 2010. Maybe even 2009, but I know it was dead early on. So I'm going to try and tackle the long-standing request for a little bit. I think there's a few others. Let me just see what else is on my thingy list. Oh god, you know, I haven't updated the some of this. Let's see. I think Paynex Killer's Fable. That was requested quite a while back. I can't remember when Paynex Killer requested that, but I think that was actually at least I think that's been about at least 6 years on that one. So that's one that's been waiting for a while. What else has there been? I guess also Star Wars Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcasts. That's been requested for ages by James Bond 235. I don't think James Bond 235, unless he took an alias, is even appears in this chat anymore. I could be wrong on that, obviously, but I don't think that person even has been seen in my chat for ages, to my recollection. But that's been there for ages. You know, that's another one that's been around. And I guess also the Super Mario World 2, by the one that Mutt requested eons ago, that's been in the pipeline. So those are a couple of ones that amazing game. Yeah, I've heard about the Star Wars ones being pretty good. And then what else is there? There's also Draugen's list as well. Unreal 1 and 2. And I guess also another one that you requested was Silent Hill Homecoming. I think those were the ones that you've waited years for me to play. And everything else is kind of sort of more recent-ish to some extent. So I'm planning to be tackling those in the next couple of weeks. The ones that people have been waiting on. So Unreal 1 and 2, Fable, that Star Wars game, Super Mario World 2, and Silent Hill Homecoming. Because those are the requests that people have been waiting years to bring to play. So I'm going to tackle those over the next few months. And then we'll go from there. But yeah, Unreal 1 and 2 is going to be the next other game I'm going to play. I'm going to do the Iron Man League. I'm actually tempted to do that today, actually. I might do that later today. I might do the Iron Man League later today. Like a few hours or something. Before I go out to poker tonight. The cheap poker. And then I can, but after I've done that, I can then crack on with Unreal 1 and 2. That's something I've been dying to play for a little bit. And Unreal's a big name in old school FPS games, so why not? So, I know that a few less people are going to come and watch me play the other games that isn't Doom, isn't FPS, but I kind of hope that over time that a few more people stick around for both types of stream. But don't worry, I'm not going to stop playing Doom stuff. I am going to do Doom things. There's plenty of Doom things I want to play too. I've got the community chest series all lined up. I know I've said that a bazillion times over 7 years, and I'm dead serious. I am gonna fucking do it, I swear. Eventually. And obviously there's other WoDs coming out that I want to play. And the play testing's not gonna stop. The play testing streams aren't gonna be super regular, but I will try and do them when I can. The mapping streams will become more regular because I need to get them done, a map done by the end of the year. But basically, I'm now going to be both a Doom streamer and a variety streamer. And I hope that you all stick around for both. Or not. If you don't, if you only want to come for one thing, that's fine. I don't mind. I'm doing this all for fun. All right. Wow. This probably is going to be the shortest sweet state ever, unless the audience questions go on for an hour. I did say this would be quite a short one. I'm guessing by the fact there's not a lot of chat discussion about some of the bigger points that perhaps a lot of you are quite happy with what I've said, but I'm sort of accepting my rage issues. I'm going to try and provide a nice balance, but I'm not going to sort of beat myself up every time I get a little upset. And about the abandonment of the part-time job mentality and all the other stuff I've talked about today. So I now open the floor to any questions from the audience. You got anything you want to say? Now is the time to ask. Now you have my undivided attention. I have my undivided attention. Oh, is that a bird out there? Ooh, look a bird. Sorry. Audience questions time. Any questions you want to ask? What razor do I use? What razor? Fuck. I'd have to go and check what it was. I don't actually know what that fucking razor is. It's like an electric one. I use an electric razor. A Gillette Max. It's not a Gillette one, I don't think. I'd have to go and check actually. Now, let me just go and look upstairs. In the meantime, you can stare into the eyes of this weird. Oh, God, I need to put the camera for about to do that. Whoa, careful. Careful. Hey, stop it. No. Bloody camera. God. Stop doing that. Okay, no. Okay. Ah, God damn it. The fucking wire keeps going off at an angle. I really wish it wouldn't do that. No, stop. Okay, while I go and check what the razor is, you can stare into the eyes of this ghost. Stare into the eyes of the ghost and get spooked. So I'll be back in a sec. I'll just go get the razor. Answer your question, Dave.
Also, hello.
I'm scary! Woo! Alright. Oh, jeez. Ah! What are you doing to the camera? Okay, there we go. Fucked up my fucking camera for a sec there. Hey, Scotty. But yeah, here is the razor that I use. There it is. Cute. Ah! So, hey, Scotty. Yeah, this is the one I use. Just an electric one. I'm totally not sponsored by this razor company, by the way, just to let you know. This is not like an influencer's plug. This is just what I use, you know? I use this one, and it's like the best thing ever, and I totally recommend that you all go out and buy one and use the code below, wow.com/JohnSuitepee, to get 20% off your first order. Fuck that shit. Wow. So that's the kind of razor I use. Yes, the electric razor. You know, it works, so whatever. So are there any other questions? I enjoy scraping a sharp piece of metal against my skin. Okay. Yeah, we're at the point of audience questions, Scotty. I can try and give a summation of the sweet state if you want. Basically, I'm more accepting of my rage issues. I'm not going to try and beat myself up every time I get mad, but I'm going to make sure I don't go too far. I'm abandoning the part-time job mentality because I want to do a fun stream rather than just focus on trying to make this a part-time job. I mean, especially while I'm living here where I don't have as much options as I'd like. I will be playing Doom Eternal. The King Ghost target got met. I'm going to provide variety with Doom and other games. With other games alongside Doom, I mean, focus on tackling one dying request first in the thing. So that's going to be like Unreal, Fable, Star Wars, Dark Forces Jedi Outcast, Silent Hill Homecoming, and Super Mario World 2. Bridge Burner's a new mod, and we're audience questions. So anyone have any more questions for me? What time is it now? Off 12? Yeah, I think I will actually do the Iron Man run a little later. I'm going to take advantage of the fact my mum's not coming back till late tonight. So, if I can get the, Ian? Who the fuck's Ian? the Iron Man stream done today, then tomorrow I can start playing Unreal. Which is going to be great. I want to get all that done before Doom Eternal drops. Yeah, Rage, Screw the Dream Job, Doom Eternal, Grinding Shit, Bridge Burns and Mod. Okay, yes, that's it. Super Mario World is a tool game. I know. That should be interesting. I'm sure. Who is Ian? Ian Man, top bloke, so I hear. I don't know who Ian Man is. I didn't mean Ian, I meant Iron Man. There's like a couple of letters missing, a Ron and a M. Iron Man. So is Unreal. Good deathmatch gameplay. Yeah, Unreal. I'm going to be playing Unreal 1 and 2 next. Strauken gifted me them ages ago, and obviously Unreal was a big part of the old school FPS scheme, and I've never played Unreal or even seen any footage of it. So it's going to be a complete surprise as to what it's going to be like. So, yeah, I'm going to be playing the single player stuff, not Unreal Tournaments. And if I can do the Iron Man stream today, then tomorrow I could start Unreal 1. And Unreal 2, I've heard not good things about Unreal 2, to be honest, but I'm not going to look into that. I'm just going to go in and play it myself, you know. I mean, it can't be as bad as Blood 2. And I've seen stuff of that, and that's why I'm never going to touch Blood 2. It looks terrible. I finished it a couple months ago. Funny me being a fan of such a long time, but I never played all of it until now. I guess you got more into the multiplayer stuff. Hey, Magus. Magus. So, any other questions for me? Anyone? I think this might be the shortest sweet state that I've recorded, to be honest, which is not a bad thing. These don't all have to last 2 hours plus, to be honest. Some of these might just be quite short. As long as I get the key points across, who cares? I kind of want to replay it at some point. Isn't Bridge Burner usually asleep or at work when you stream? No, I don't think so. He sometimes is around, sometimes he isn't. What's the color of my clothing? What do you mean by that, Dave? Clothing. No, not always, Scotty. I think he does tune in sometimes. I mean, oh, the thing around the ceiling. Okay, it's like a light brown. It's like a light sort of brown. Yeah, this room hasn't really changed all that much. Since we moved in. I mean, a few other rooms have received... Well, actually, I tell her why. I think my mum did sort of brush up the clothing when we first came in. But that's been about it. This is basically just now the computer room. And... slash... There's like a TV here as well. And there's... laundry as well. So it's kind of like a study, I guess we call it. But it's not really much studying going on here. Not most of the time, anyway. But now, I think Bridge Burner's around some of the time, Scotty. Well, that's it. No. Okay. Maybe other people want to ask questions, Dave. Now no one's going to ask a question. No, they don't. Lots of Revenant Fireball studying happens. You leave now, and you come back in 2 hours and play Baker's Dozen and do some other shit. Sorry, a bit tired. I got a fucking dentist appointment tomorrow as well. God, I got a filling in my fucking tooth again. So that's fun. I get to have a nice, pleasant Thursday. I get to wake up in the morning, have a filling, go to college, get stuck in traffic on the way back home. But then I get to come home and play Unreal. So tomorrow, the playing of Unreal will be the highlight of the day. I mean, I'm not going out to poker tomorrow night. Because I fucking hate where they've moved to. I don't want to spend a lot of money, so... I'd rather stay home and play Unreal instead. So that's it. No other questions from anyone? Nothing at all? Not a peek? Hey, don't call me on the 13th. Yes, unreal. I'm planning on doing the Iron Man League attempt in a few hours from now. And then tomorrow I can start with Unreal. That's the plan. But, well, that's not a question, Pineapple, because there's no question mark in it. So that's more of just an
open statement.
But otherwise, a question is a thing that people ask in the hope of getting answers. It is a statement that... Nice, looking forward to seeing you play through it. Yeah, I'm sure a few people are going to look forward to the Unreal playthrough. I mean, it's like one of the big old-school FPS giants, and I've never even seen it. Very much of it at all, so... I imagine it's going to be quite the game. I mean, when I played a medieval, people said the combat was a bit Unreal inspired. So I guess I might expect something similar to a medieval, possibly. But
I guess I'll see for myself.
Don't know why I'm yawning now. Shouldn't really be yawning. Okay, well, I guess that's it then. I guess everyone's pretty happy with everything. So, I'm gonna do the Iron Man League run in like a few hours from now. I don't know how many hours it's gonna be. It's gonna be at least 2 hours, possibly. I'll see how I get on with everything else. But I'm gonna do the Iron Man League of Baker's Dozen in like a few hours from now. And then tomorrow night, I will start playing Unreal. Unreal 1, so that should be cool. And I'm hoping to get all the Unreal stuff done before March the 20th, before Doom Eternal drops. So thank you all for tuning in for this sweet state. And I'll catch you all in the future. Have a good day if I don't see you later on. Peace out.
Goodbye, everybody. Have a good day. Waka 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 waka.